this week's podcast of Pansy Group is The German Origins by Mr. Brahim Aghili.
The concept of a German ethnicity is linked to Germanic tribes of antiquity in Central Europe. The early Germans originated on the North German plain as well as southern Scandinavia. By the 2nd century BC, the number of Germans was significantly increasing and they began expanding into Eastern Europe and southward into Celtic territory. During antiquity, these Germanic tribes remained separate from each other and did not have writing systems at that time. In the European Iron Age, the area that is now Germany was divided into the Celtic Latene Horizon in southern Germany and the Jastorf culture in northern Germany. By 55 BC, the Germans had reached the Danube River and had either assimilated or otherwise driven out the Celts who had lived there and had spread west into what is now Belgium and France. Conflicts between the Germanic tribes and the forces of Rome under Julius Caesar forced major Germanic tribes to retreat to the east bank of the Rhine. Roman Emperor Augustus in 12 BC ordered the conquest of the Germans, but the catastrophic Roman defeat at the Battle of the Teutoburg Forest resulted in the Roman Empire abandoning its plans to completely conquer Germania. Germanic peoples in Roman territory were culturally Romanized, and although much of Germania remained free of direct Roman rule, Rome deeply influenced the development of German society, especially the adoption of Christianity by the Germans who obtained it from the Romans. In Roman-held territories with Germanic populations, the Germanic and Roman peoples intermarried and Roman, Germanic, and Christian traditions intermingled. The adoption of Christianity would later become a major influence in the development of a common German identity. The first major public figure to speak of a German people in general was the Roman figure Tacitus in his work Germania around 100 BC. However, an actual united German identity and ethnicity did not exist then, and it would take centuries of development of German culture until the concept of a German ethnicity began to become a popular identity. The Germanic peoples, during the migrations period, came into contact with other peoples. In the case of the populations settling in the territory of modern Germany, they encountered Celts to the south and Balts and Slavs towards the east. The Limes Germanicus was breached in AD 260. Migrating Germanic tribes commingled with the local Gallo-Roman populations in what is now Swabia and Bavaria. The arrival of the Huns in Europe resulted in Hun conquest of large parts of Eastern Europe. The Huns initially were allies of the Roman Empire who fought against Germanic tribes. But later, the Huns cooperated with the Germanic tribe of the Ostrogoths, and large numbers of Germans lived within the lands of the Hunnic Empire of Attila. Attila had both Hunnic and Germanic families and prominent Germanic chiefs amongst his close entourage in Europe. The Huns living in Germanic territories in Eastern Europe adopted the Eastern Germanic language as their lingua franca. A major part of Attila's army were Germans. During the Huns' campaign against the Roman Empire after Attila's unexpected death, the Hunnic Empire collapsed, with the Huns disappearing as a people in Europe, who either escaped into Asia or otherwise blended in amongst Europeans. The migration period peoples later coalesced into a German ethnicity where the Germanic tribes of the Saxons, Franki, Thuringi, Alemanni, and Bavari. These five tribes, sometimes with the inclusion of the Frisians, are considered as the major groups to take part in the formation of the Germans. By the 9th century, the large tribes which lived on the territory of modern Germany had been united under the rule of the Frankish king Charlemagne, known in German as Karl der Große. Much of what is now eastern Germany became Slavonic-speaking after these areas were vacated by Germanic tribes, which had migrated into the former areas of the Roman Empire.